Hey guys, Stealth here. Today I got something completely different. This is Crossout. It's a new game that's currently in closed beta, created by Gaijin. Gaijin Entertainment, the creators of Warthunder. What you need to do here is, I believe the backstory is you're a scavenger, or, I'm not really sure. It seems to be a little bit of the Mad Max situation, the Mad Max crafting thing. And what you need to do is destroy your enemy, a bit like Robocraft that I used to cover early on my channel. You can see you can destroy the enemy team. Blue is friendly, red is enemy, as usual. Now you can see that some of these vehicles look quite different from mine, and it seems that they have gotten some upgraded parts. Now the more you... What the hell is that on the front of your unit? The more you upgrade your parts, the more your battle rating goes up. Same as you have in War Thunder. The higher the battle rating, the more your vehicle is going to get tiered up into more difficult matches against more skilled players. Or, well, not per se more skilled. I mean, we're talking War Thunder. But people have been playing the game for longer. And the entire purpose of the game is to build vehicles. Currently, I'm pretty much grinding out with the stock vehicle because I don't have anything else unlocked yet. And what I need to do here is just destroy as many enemies as possible along with my team in order to get new parts unlocked, level up, and carry on. Now you can see these matches last a really, really short while. I leveled up to level 2. I got a sticker, flawless. I got a reward, a weapons radiator. This is very useful because it means I can keep my machine gun firing for longer. And I got something else, but I went by a little bit too quickly. Alright, our base is here. Their base is there. You can see here my battle rating, or PS. I think that's power something. I'm 792, and you can see that some of these vehicles have power ratings which are way higher, up in the 2300s, so these things are probably far, far more powerful than my own. Now, let's have a look. I'm going to stick close to my team. And if I want to, I can use my handbrake, like that. Slipping and sliding all over the place. Just going to try and do this guy in. There we go, kill assists. Who's one of our most powerful members? Oh, got everyone here. Enemy destroyed. That was a bit of a kill steal. I'm not firing the entire time because my weapon is overheating, it seems. Come on, go down. Kill assists. It seems that they only got 3 members on the enemy team left. So let's go and hunt those guys down. Yeah, driving knee-deep into the water is not going to make your vehicle go any faster. Maybe good for cooling your engine, but I still wouldn't recommend it. Samantha here. I'm actually considering that we may be fighting bots. I wouldn't be surprised if they start you out in a PvE mode. Go to the garage. Because the garage is where the magic happens. There we go. I leveled up. I'm level 2. I can build medium wheels, van roofs, planks and sides, as well as square covers and tin caps. Wonderful. Now, this is my vehicle build. Whoops. I can walk around it. I can take parts off of it. That's the entire cabin. And you can pretty much build this. Whoops, that's not quite aligned. Like you did with Legos. Or I'm saying did, maybe you still play with it. I don't know. I got a car jack here, which overturns your vehicle. Oh, this is something that apparently they learned from War Thunder. Make sure you have something in the game that's going to allow you to get your vehicle righted when you need to, because at some point you will flip yourself over. Got a frame here. Let's see, do I have some sort of... can I park this somewhere? No? Okay. Anyway, let's go to escape. I can create new units or create new stuff by manufacturing it. Before I can do that though, I first need to get the required parts. For example, the snapper, which is crossbow launching bolts. Look at the power score. That is 3 times the thing that I have on my vehicle. But for example, for small wheels, I first need to get scrap metal, otherwise I cannot build it. And then it takes a couple of seconds, and I wouldn't be surprised at all if this just keeps going up and up and up. The more time you need to get this stuff done, the more powerful the item will be. Alright, back to the menu. Let's see, what's market? Is this like a market between players where you can buy stuff? Looks like I'm flat out broke. You got weapons here, medium machine gun, a pyre launcher, homing infrared missile. Okay. 20mm auto cannons, turret cannons, auto cannons, a wasp launcher, unguided rocket, 88mm cannon. If I'm not mistaken, the 88mm was a very powerful weapon used in the Second World War to kill tanks. HMG. What's this? I'm really just in the phase of getting started with the game. I have played this for maybe 10 minutes before I actually started to record the video, so I'm really, really new. Light engine. Can accelerate the vehicle to a very high speed. Acceleration very significantly decreases with increased vehicle mass. Yes, of course. Powerful engine. A sight. Allows zooming in on enemies. That's useful. So how can I get some of this? You can get more money by selling something on the market or by purchasing coins in the store. Yeah, right. That's their money-making way, probably. Your tank is full. Fuel is spent on raids and refills every day. Right. I'm not sure if I'm playing against bots or if I'm actually playing against other people. Battle. This is the raids. Ah, right. This is missions. PvP. So this is what I was doing. Let's see if I can do a raid. PvE. A team of players fights raiders. Easy defense. A small raider party is attacking our pump jacks, and so we spend so much time repairing them and installing them. Protect the jacks from enemy waves. Reward is coupons and copper. Okay, requires 3 to 4 people, and I need 10 fuel. Well, I have 200, so I should be fine. It's the only one I can do. The normal defense I can only do when I'm at level 10. Right, and I need a specific amount of power something. I still don't know what the PS is. So let's try a raid, see how that works. Average waiting time is 7 seconds. That means that there's quite a few people on playing this, so that's good. Let's see, I'm here with Raxo, Pappis 1, and Tazmez. I'm by far the weakest player. Look at that. 792 combat rating versus 2100-3500. I'm gonna stick with my buddies in order not to go down. Whoa. I didn't even know what that was. Protects. Contact spotted. You can see I seem to be barely doing any damage against this guy. It seems that most of the damage is being done by my enemy, or so by my allies. Gun's overheating again. He's down. Sweet. Oh. What happened? Oh, my cabin's out of alignment. I wouldn't be surprised if that impacts the way that the vehicle handles. Look at that, his entire rear just exploded like that. Cutthroat. Kill assist. There's a few more, another cutthroat. This guy seems to be centered on me now. Swing it around. Somebody just decided to blow his rear off, and his gun. So he's not actually that much of an issue anymore. Let's completely grind this guy down to bits. There. Sit there and stay there. Bye-bye. Pump jack defended, number 1. Done. Alright. So I'm getting kill assists, but no actual kills. Tasmaz, who I think... Whoa, this slows me down. Tasmaz, who I think has the strongest vehicle, is getting the most kills. Unsurprisingly, of course. Protect. With my terribly out-of-alignment vehicle. That just looks ridiculous. It's because I picked up the cabin and didn't place it back correctly. Next wave, 30 seconds. But we got guys already coming in. Oh dear. Looks like I got quite a bit of aggro on me right now. Close range, you're always more likely to hit that. Come on. He has some sort of grinder things in front of his vehicle. Down. Enemy destroyed! My first kill. Yeah, that's nice. This is, I don't know, this seems to be the love child between a Humvee and a school bus. Really not sure what that's about. Things overheating again. Come on, you're not going anywhere. No, you're not going to make it away. I know I should be defending my objective, but I'm gonna get this kill. Oh, you still have a gun? Right, so long as I stay behind you, you're not gonna fire at me at all, are you? Deconstructor. Is that good, or is that an enemy? Gee, would you just go down already? Bloody hell. Thank you. Look at that. I'm at 2 kills. Tasmaz is at 13. And it seems that we gotta defend the next objective. Ooh. I'm sliding all over the place. Holy hell. Could you take that missile launcher and go somewhere else with it? Or what is that? Is it the... Uh-oh. Oh, he's not going for me. Some of these wheels off, make it easier to kill. Yeah, I think if he's burning, that's not a good thing. I'm gonna stay away from him before he takes me down and explodes. Alright, looks like we gotta move on. Because I wouldn't be surprised if that objective is now being attacked. Another cutthroat. Oh, this is another Humvee school bus. Nice. Problem, have you? Boom. I've taken remarkably little damage. It seems that they are entirely not interested in going after me. I stand corrected. This guy seems to have malicious intent. Oh, slipping and sliding. Yeah, you're not going anywhere. Oh, ouch. What happened there? I just got completely blown up. Let's have a look at some of the other vehicles. This is Puppis. Puppis seems to be using an autocannon. And something of a small howitzer. Bloody hell, these guys are getting completely overwhelmed. How's the other guy doing? Is that Tasmis? Tasmax. Ooh, Tasmax is not doing too well here. No! Tasmax! I gotta look. I really like the look of this thing. I like the tracks. This thing is built like a sort of tank. And he just keeps racking up the kills, too. Look at that. I'm doing, what, 6 to 10 damage with my gun? He's doing pretty reliably 20. He should be dead. Next. That objective, though, is going down. It seems to be the last wave, but I don't think we can make it. I think that if they grind that objective down to 0, we lose. And this guy just has his main autocannon left. Oh, he's burning! No! No. Damn it. Stupid question, but how do I respawn? The vehicle has been killed. Yeah, we've been defeated. I gotta figure out how I can respawn this thing. Alright, mission failed. XP received 255. Reward 3 copper. And I seem to have gotten at least some XP for it. So that's good. Yep, turn to garage. Easy defense, defeat. Yep, unfortunately. Now, let's please align that terribly spaced thing like that. And I would like to build that cooling thing that I unlocked. So that should be here, I think. Is it? Manufacturing requires level 7. Yeah, I'm not quite there yet. Oh, these guys have all sorts of different manufacturing things. What is that? Requires level 13? Oh, hello. Or just take a Reaper autocannon. That thing reminds me of the thing that's mounted in the Thunderbolts, the A-10. Scavengers have a mammoth cannon, a hurricane launcher, launches a volley of 4 homing missiles. Wow, and an Apollo generator. Adds 4 energy. Okay, when destroyed, deals 1,000 damage in an 8-meter radius. Whatever. For now, though, I'm gonna have to keep with the engineers, it seems. ST, is that strong or something? More durable and has better mass tolerance. Yeah, but they both say that. No idea. A bada boom? Lays burning barrels filled with explosive materials and metal chunks. The barrels explode on contact with vehicles or when hit with any weapon. So you can even turn your vehicle into a mine layer, it seems. Wow. Equipment, paint, light machine gun. Alright, I wouldn't be surprised if I'm gonna level up the fastest when I battle in not raids but missions. And if I'm not sure how I get this, but so just get the machine gun. I got a light machine gun, get a carjack. Oh, right, that seems to be what I already have, and I just have to keep going until I reach level 3. Alright, let's do that. See if I can get that done in this video. Just reaching level 3. Your car will be ready in the next round. Now, let's have a look. How do I spawn, if any? Controls. Lifting jack is R. That's useful to know. If I'm ever flipped over, I need to do that. Screenshotting, forward, back, primary, secondary, special equipment. Seriously, how do you spawn? Space is not it. With space, I just switched from one vehicle to the next. This, by the way, this dude has 6 kills with what seems to be just a bunch of machine guns on his vehicle. And a whole set of different wheels as compared to mine. We got Wicket over here. Okay. This, to me, makes no sense. I'm not sure when exactly I'm going to be joining in. Oh, okay. Right now. Sure. So again, I'm the weakest vehicle here. Along with Ijin Pitts. Against, well, medium levels, it seems. Medium levels. Okay, so one of our strongest guys. No idea. Oh, Demon was the top leader last time around. Sorry. Let's have a look at this guy. Let's see what he can do. Oh, Sandra. Whoa! Dude! He just drove right into all of us. So we got three people killed already. Still though, these usernames are too generic. I think I'm dealing with bots here. Especially with their limited intelligence, I'd say. I mean, a player would have turned around by now. I'm just chasing this guy. Boom. Helen destroyed. Where's the last one? Somewhere back here near the enemy base, maybe? Holy hell! Oh, okay, that didn't do any damage. Hello, Anthony. How would you like to go down? Boom, victory. Fighter, finish 5 battles. Good. Did I make it to level? No. Still at level 2. Reward, carjack, and 3 scrap metal. I'm gonna have to get a lot of scrap metal before I'm gonna be actually able to get up to the next level of production. See, we have all these weird human-created usernames. They have all the standard stuff. So I think I'm dealing with bots here. Okay, the armor's powerful dude. Yeah, still in on. I still got Demon 04 here somewhere. These rounds, though, they last really, really short. Only 3 minutes at best. And we don't even seem to get that. Boom. There's Matthew. I'm sitting duck here in the water. Goodbye, Matthew. Okay, this vehicle is definitely not supposed to go aquatic. It is not exactly what you would call amphibious. Someone over there. Come on. Oh, hello, Damon. That's one wheel down. And guess who's in the water again? Boom! Look at that, second kill in a match. I'm going places. Yes, I'm level 3. To garage. Yes, return to garage. Yay, level 3. Total part limit raised to 25. Paint thinner, light machine gun, isotope 239. A frame, a van roof, a square cover, a van side. You've been in a few battles, though there's still enough parts. Time to learn something new. Some parts can be broken down into scrap. Cool, right? Okay. Sometimes it's better than filling your storage with useless bits and pieces. So select a part and disassemble it. It's probably not the right time to tell you this, but surplus parts can be sold on the black market, or you can buy something. Okay, so storage. Is this what I have? Did I somehow claim these? I guess so. So I want to sell this. How do I do that? Sell. Perfect. Yes. I sold it, now I got a little bit of credits. I got a light machine gun there, I got a starter minigun. Power score 155, power score 240, so now we're getting somewhere. A couple of frames. Okay, no idea what that is. Right, so build. I want to build something from my inventory, so I'm going to add another light machine gun. I really doubt that's going to work very well. I mean, it's going to be right on top of the radiator. And I don't really have a lot of room for it. Can I just park them here, like this? If I'm engaging a vehicle from the side, this is not really going to help me. If I'm engaging a vehicle from the front, I have quite a lot of firepower to throw at them. Now, let's see if I can use the other thing here, the weapon radiator. To cool this thing down. And it would be nice if I could just get this thing inside here. Can I rotate it? Yeah, that's not the way that I was looking for. Oh, that apparently resets. Again, still learning. Whoops! I may have just deleted a bit too much here. Like, my engine. There. Yeah, we're not gonna talk about that. That didn't happen. Okay, so let's make this a 4x4 frame. And let's take this wheel off. And that wheel off. Take that wheel off. And whoops, that one. And now put on some of these medium wheels. See, that instantly looks better. And you're gonna see it right there. Get out of my way. Next up, medium wheel. Whoops. No, come on. Don't be a bitch about it. Medium wheel there. And add my final medium wheel there. Okay. Now I want to get something that can make this a little bit more cohesive. A square cover, a starter wheel. I think I deleted my car jack, didn't I? Oh crap, I left building mode. Weapon radiator. This thing, though, is not that likely to flip over. I mean, I think I can get away without getting one of those radiators. Let's see, can I rotate this thing somehow? Stay there. Or can I just put this back into storage somehow? I don't know. Fuel barrel allows to receive fuel in PvP. Do I need that? I didn't get any kind of notification about fuel whatsoever. Alright, let's just try and cover this thing up as best we can. I need to rotate that. There. Okay. Fan side. Whoops. How do you... No, not like that. Control click. Ah, that's copy apparently. Can I get another weapon radiator thing? I don't have any. What I can do, maybe, is make this thing longer. Yeah, I can make the vehicle bigger if I want to. So let's go with a 4x4 frame. And that means that I should be able to yep, I can... I can add some more wheels to this. Just because. Wow, this thing is hideous. Let's take it out for a test drive. Oh, hang on. I figured it out. ST, smartass, means steering. Means you can move around with your vehicle. So what I need to do is get the right wheels in the right location. This is a small steering wheel. And no, not a steering wheel, but a wheel that can steer. I'll get there eventually. Small steering wheel. No, whoops. I really hope this thing has a control... Yep, it does have a control Z feature. Perfect. Stay there. You attach here. And that other massive wheel that I splunked down somewhere here. Come on, you. You're gonna go here. Let's put it somewhere slightly more towards the middle. There. Okay, let's try this again. Test drive. Oh, whoa! This thing is mobile. Nice. This I can work with. And with two machine guns, of course, I'm doing more damage. Oh, this is a clone of my vehicle. Get out of here, imposter. Alright, this is not mucking about. Let's see if this thing holds up in battle. And end the video there. Get the machine gun. Got the shotgun. What's that? Small radar. Increases enemy detection range to 300 meters. That's useful. Let's go to that. Some parts are unwelded. Okay. So I guess I need to clean up my garage. So that has to be put back into storage somehow? Right click. Yes, that's it. I just need to right click these parts and they're gonna put them back into storage. There. Now I should be able to fight. You will be ready in the next round. Okay. So let's see what kind of crazy designs these guys come up with. This one is not doing very well. We have Alec over here. Let's see if we can find Metro 2033. Yes, here he is. I'm not sure if he's AFK or something, but he is not working. Same for this one. And that one. Ah, there we go. Alright, so my power rating went up to 1161. Let's see how this thing performs in an actual battlefield. I really find this bridge rather suspicious. I really don't feel safe. Yeah, got one. Who would like to go next? Oops. Guess who doesn't have a ram on his vehicle? Perfect. Wait for help. Wait for help. Right. I got a kill assist. Explain to me how that works. Somebody help? Whoa, okay. Victory. Well, that was a pretty terrible ending. I mean, I just managed to flip my vehicle upside down. And apparently if you don't have a ram, you're not going to actually make it back up alive. Or make it back up on your own. Alright, so that is this first video on Crossout. I've added a link in the description so you can find out more about this game. You can get into the closed beta. I'm not sure if there is a friends list. There probably is. I just haven't found it yet. Here. Yep, friends list. If you want to add me so we can join up together as far as that's possible, I'm stealth 17-2 or stealth 172 because someone had already taken stealth 17, the imposters. Anyway, let me know what your thoughts are on this. I find it quite hilarious to play this, I gotta say. I'm really having fun with it, and I hope you have too. So let me know what your thoughts are on the game. If you have any things that I really should know that I currently don't, please fill me in, because the more I know about the game, the better I can play it. Thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you soon for the next one.